tukipiga together tunatesa. 254 sindo kusema we. Let me love you the African way. Let me love you like an African lady. Ikuite baba, nanita mama. Ikuite baba, nanita mama. The African way.
Unobila mfupa, unavyokata.
Well, a very good afternoon to all of you watching us from wherever in the country or outside the borders. Those who are streaming online, karibuni sana. Monday football, that's what we have right now. We are 10 minutes into our allocated time. Roba says alikuwa na technical problem kidogo, lakini we are on. Do not worry about that. So, we'll get right into the show. Our guest today is Bandari FC, FKF Shield winners. They won yesterday 3-1 convincingly against Kariobangi Shark, dethroning the champions. And as you can see in the studio, we don't have the full team because they've taken their celebrations to Mombasa, but the key people are here with us in studio, Banat.
Right, Michael King, of course, good afternoon. Indeed, episode number 11, Bandari FC in the studio this afternoon just to reflect on the season as well as their victory yesterday, winning the FKF Shield Cup. I'm sure you're wondering where one of our teammates is because, you know, it's a team. And of course, that is Mukami Wambora. Well, we'll be joining with, linking up with her in a few, because she's not in Kenya, she's in Europe. She's been following the action as far as European football, the action that has been happening in the past 1 week, the Europa League, the Champions League, and we'll be interacting with her in the course of this show. And of course, as usual, the man providing for us a soundtrack for the show is the man on the decks. I'm sure he's very disappointed with what transpired last week, as far as the Europa League is concerned, because he's an avid Arsenal fan, but nonetheless, DJ Crossfade on the ones and twos, good afternoon to you. And of course, Michael Kinyi, what a show we have this afternoon.
There's money to begin now today, 10,000 shillings. And today we are throwing it to you, the fans. We'll give you the lines to call and 10,000 bob up for grabs. Niko nao tayari, Robasha nipatia 10,000 bob up for grabs for whoever is going to answer my questions on Bandari FC. Today it's all about Bandari. We already have given you leakage, two questions, answers are already there. So let's see how keen you are. We'll be giving you the number to call on your screens at the right time. But for now, send us your questions for Bandari FC at Bernard Ndong, at Citizen TV, at Michael Kinyi. We'll be glad to share them with the coach. And any comments that you might have, actually, send us those ones and we'll be able to share with the team in studio. Bernard.
Right, let's recap what transpired over the weekend. And as we mentioned earlier, Bandari FC clinched the FKF Shield title, the first silver of the season, after edging 2018 champions Kariobangi Sharks by 3-1. Now, the finals rained off on Saturday evening and it resumed on Sunday morning with Bandari leading 2-1. Benjamin Mosha scored the third goal in the afternoon to clinch the title on the corresponding 2 million Kenya shillings. Well, staying with local football, remember the Kenyan Premier League has officially concluded last week, although there was a game that was played yesterday. But let's move on to the national football team, the Harambee Stars. Well, they are in France. This is a day number 3 that they are settling in France. Of course, they are camping at the French Rugby Federation facility and they have had 2 training sessions since their arrival last weekend. The bulk of the players are today. Of course, the bulk of the players are the ones who have joined later today. 14 are the ones who had checked in as of last week, and more are expected later this afternoon. And that includes Captain Victor Wanyama. Remember, he was present, although in the sidelines, in the Champions League final against Liverpool. And also, Michael Olunga is expected to link up with the rest of the team today. You can see the images there of the national football team as they go through their paces. Remember, Harambee Stars will be facing off against the Democratic Republic of Congo and against Madagascar in build-up friendlies before they make the long trip to Egypt, Cairo, for the 2019 African Cup of Nations. Right, as you mentioned at the beginning of the show, this afternoon we are honored to have Bandari FC. They finished second in the Kenyan Premier League, which concluded last week, although there's a game that was played last week, yesterday afternoon. And let's just remind ourselves about what this club is all about. This is a Kenyan Premier League club, obviously, that comes from Mombasa. Bandari is the name. It is a professional Kenyan football club based in Mombasa County. The club was established in 1985 and has its home ground at the Kenya Ports Authority Sports Club, or better known as the Mbaraki Sports Club, which has a capacity of 3,000 for seating fans. Now, they also have a youth team, and this is a very important component about this club, and I'm sure the CEO will be touching on this briefly. This youth team was formed in 2014, and it was set up to develop the football talents for the young players who obviously will make the pathway to join the senior team. This club was also formed to encourage young players in the coastal area to compete for the national duties, as well as joining the national under 17. A lot of players who featured in the junior levels that have come from Bandari FC, and the team is led by the youth coach, a team manager and an assistant coach. This of course is for the youth team, and also the senior team has a similar technical bench structure. The fan base is a very huge fan base. Every time you go to Mombasa, the Mbaraki Sports Club, I'm sure Mike can attest to that. They're very, very vocal fans, and hopefully we'll be able to link up with some of them in the course of this show. And these fans follow them keenly, not necessarily only in Mombasa, but even as a team traverses the country, and for them to play their league games. Their home ground, as I mentioned, is the Mbaraki Sports Ground, the venue that the club uses when they are hosting their home matches. Mike, that is just a general view of who Bandari FC is, but I'm interested in knowing the name Bandari. When did it come from? Where did that particular name originate from? I'm assuming it's because of Kenya Ports.
Of course, Bandari being the port and KPA being the main guys that have sponsored the team, that is where the name Bandari comes from. I'm joined here by the coach, Bernard Molala. Congratulations on winning the Shield yesterday and finishing second in the KPL.
Thank you, Mike.
Edward Oduor, of course, I call him TM because I've never known how to call him. I find it difficult to call him Edward Oduor because he served as a team manager of the Harambee Stars when we were doing very well, and congratulations, TM. You did well there. So, beginning, first question from what Ndong has picked up, the name Bandari. How was it coined? Did you just decide it's Bandari, or it was management thing that decided?
Bandari, as it is known, is that it's a Kiswahili word for the name port. So it is associated with the community back down there. So that's why the name came from in Kiswahili. So it being most of the fans, the management found it was more convenient to put them more closer to the team by naming the team Bandari, as in the ports. Yes.
2 seasons ago, you made a very bold decision to go for a top coach, Bernard Molala. What informed that decision? Was that the turning point of the good fortunes for Bandari?
Actually, if I draw you back, when we thought of engaging Molala as the coach, we had an initial program to develop the team in a long-term plan. As in, we had Coach Kennedy Odhiambo, who was by that time the head coach, and we had embarked on a certain project in terms of developing the team for a long term. And by that time, when Coach Kennedy was taking on the team, he was acting as an assistant with the former head coach, who was Mzee Nkata, and who left after the contract expired. So Coach Ken took over as the head coach, and he gave us the strategic plan on the way forward of how to have a long-term project for the team in terms of getting results. And by that time, we had big names in the team, and he came up with a plan that we need now to put up a foundation for the team, in a sense that it will give us the results in the long run. But patience was the most important thing, which he emphasized. And from there, we had to release the big names, because I think by that time we had finished 13th in the league standing, and so we were not performing well. And also in return, the sponsor was also not happy, in a sense that the results were not coming as what has been invested into the team. So we had to sit down with the head coach, Kennedy, and we came up with this long-term plan, whereby we engaged the youth, being helped by scouting from the region and even up country. So we came up with an overview of young players, average 23 at most, and retained 5 players, senior players, in order to propel the team, because we also needed to mix the young and the experienced players, because at that time there was no shortcut from us. We had to perform the following season. But what Coach Ken emphasized is that we need to have patience, and at the end of the day, the result will come, because he told us he had experienced this kind of scenario when he was the head coach of Nairobi City Stars. And he told us by that time, the team finished sixth position when he engaged the youth players into the team. And most of those young players were scouted by the big clubs in the country. So he said that that one also can be done with the Bandari. And by the time he was putting the project into place, he had put on all the mechanism how to work on the youth development. So we engaged those youth players, mostly from the region, and in a sense that we were working on the exposure from these youth players who were in the national schools. So he put the plan in place. By the time he was leaving, the team was lying in fifth position. That was last season. And there was a demand that from the sponsor that we need to give them the plan and the, how the project will work. So Coach Ken had some issues with the family. He had to relocate to Sudan, and there was no choice for him because it was a family matter. So we agreed with him, and we told him that this is a project which you have started. And for us, getting another coach who has got the same philosophy like yours, it will need your input also for us to get a coach who will continue with the project. So we had a short list of three coaches, and we decided to go for Malala, because I was tasked by the board of trustees to come up with a research on how and the performance of the coach who was supposed to engage, if he will be capable of handling the youth. So I did my research, and from what I got is that I emphasized that Malala was the right person to handle the team, because I had also worked with Malala when I was in the national team as the team manager. And by that time, when he was like, because of the injury, he was like now ending his career in terms of active football. He was doing courses in terms of in the line of coaching in Tanzania, back in Tanzania, where he was based. And I think what I got is that his first team as a coach was in Tanzania, the Coastal Union, whereby the team finished, I think it was in a fifth position.
Yes.
And so from there, he moved back to Kenya, and he took over Nzoia. From there, we saw that he performed very well with Nzoia. And most cases, he was engaging the youth. And his scouting was very good by that time. And Nzoia was not a big club in a sense that the investment in terms of sponsorship was there. But you could see that the team was performing very well at that level of the nationwide. Then they were promoted to the Premier League. And there, he managed to handle the team and finish in a very respectable position, I can remember. So we said that actually he was the right person to engage so that we continue with our development in the long run, for the long term. And actually, we finished at that league, we finished the second position, where it was the last leg when he took over. That was the second leg. And he managed to propel the team with the kind of material of the youth who were there by that time when Coach Ken left. So we managed to finish second position. And after that league, he said that he will continue with the same material. He will only need few players to inject into the team. So he came up with the two players. That was Brian Otieno from Nzoia, the stopper, central defender, and then the goalkeeper, Mustafa Oduor. So we continue from there. And it's been tough because as you have seen, the league was very congested, the fixture. We had also the Sportpesa Shield Cup in between. And from our location, that is where we are located down at the coast, we have to travel all the 17 matches away. Unlike our colleagues or other teams who are centralized, and more so, they are playing like 17 matches in between us and away, but they are still at home. So the coach came up with a very good plan in terms of planning of how the fixture is. And the management was very supportive in terms of how are we going to make it work, and the fixture is congested. So we were given the mandate to come up with a plan, and the board proposed that the plan was okay. And the sponsor also came on board through our patron, Bwana Manduku, who has been very close all along throughout the season and monitoring how the team is performing. And actually the sponsor, which is Kenya Ports Authority, has been working with us as the board of the trustee of the team very closely. So actually, that's how we came to engage Mwalala into the team.
Okay. Coach, at one point, walisema farasi ni mbili.
Ndio.
Mathare United, Bandari. Farasi moja akabaki nyuma. Mengangana, you finished second. Where do you say that you actually thought? Because I remember four games. Is it three or four games before the end of the season? You said it would be very difficult to bridge that gap. Where do you think you faltered in the season in fighting for the KPL title?
I think the element of fatigue, Mike. As you can recall, we went for SportPesa Super Cup in Dar es Salaam.
Uh-huh.
And we played like three matches, or it was three. Very tough matches, international games. So the element of fatigue came through. Because after playing Sharks on the finals, mm-hmm. we had to travel to Kakamega.
Homeboys?
Yeah, by road to play Homeboys. We lost. I think that's the same point where we lost track. And I think the element fatigue, as I said, it became something like an issue, a big one for my team. As you put it, we are the only team that's traveling for almost 400-500 kilometers to honor away matches.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. You see, teams like, teams from Nairobi, we have like 10 teams in Nairobi.
True.
So out of those 10 teams, you see, they can only travel to Nakuru. You see, a team like Gor Mahia, the champions, they will play like 18 matches in Nairobi.
True.
At the same time, teams coming from rural areas, like
Chemele,
they will come.
Yes.
So out of 18, you have another 7 matches or 6 playing in Nairobi.
Yes.
For us, we have to travel and travel and travel.
Guaranteed 17 games away.
17 guaranteed. By bus. We don't have that budget of maybe you can board a plane or something like that. So I think the element of fatigue really cost us this season.
Mm-hmm.
But now that the calendar has changed, I think we'll do better because matches will be kidogo apart.
We used to laugh at Gor Mahia when they come from continental assignments and they have a game, and when they don't perform, we say, "Oh, wajiwezi." What are the challenges of coming from that level? Like, for example, you played in Tanzania,
yep.
High tempo games. You come back to the league and you have to psych up the players and tell them, "Guys, we need these points." How difficult is it to pick up from that level where, especially you've lost the final and you have to tell the players now, we have to fight for this KPL title?
I think what I can say is it's all about the players now. It's not about the coach. Lucky enough, I find a group of players who are more than disciplined. You see, without discipline, you cannot manage these games. But I found players who are really disciplined. They will manage themselves after a match. They will rest, take a lot of liquid, drink a lot of water. And you know, now through that, you can manage the next game. Mm-hmm. I also reminded them that losing a final, they are young. This final will come. And Axel, it happened. Now we have won the Shield Cup. Now they can recall what I told them in Dar es Salaam, that you can lose these matches, but God's time is always the best.
Mm-hmm.
You keep on working, good things will come.
You raise a very emotive debate, and when we look at it in retrospect, there was a point in it. You said, and last week we were with Mathare here, Coach Salim backed you up and said, you find that when you have to play in Chemele, like one zita viwanja za miwa, when you have to play in Chemele, Kichaka, you have to go to Soni, Kichaka, you have to go to Nzoia, Kichaka nyingine, picking points from these places is very difficult because of the surface. But the champions, Gor Mahia, were allowed to move the games, also their opponents were allowed to move the games away from the Kichaka. What effect does this have on the title chase?
Kubwa sana.
Mm.
Kubwa sana.
Yes.
In fact, you see, let's try and see where Bandari lost some points.
Yes.
We drew at Nzoia.
Yes.
Gordon.
Sudi.
Sudi. Gordon go there.
But they lost their game against Nzoia, actually.
No. Okay, yeah.
They played in Mumias, yeah. They lost.
They lost.
Uh-huh.
Okay. Now, we went to Chemini.
Yes.
We lost. You know, I think we drew.
We drew.
Yeah.
Yes.
We went to Sony. Mm. We lost.
Yes.
When you compare the gap on the points,
yes,
you can see where we dropped those points up on the Maligori Olive Token.
What is your recommendation? Because we had this debate and Ngala from Gor Mahia called in and said, it is not us who take ourselves out of those viwanjas. Mm-hmm. It is the federation, I mean KPL, that takes us there. And in any case, why isn't FC performing and they don't play in those places? Yeah? Because I remember your biggest problem was, how many injuries did you pick from those viwanjas?
So many. So many. I think I lost to Adri.
Yes.
There's a time I lost Yema. There's a time I lost Bena for the whole season. My second goalie, Mustafa Odwar, I lost them. Now, I cannot speak for FC not performing. All I can say is that ukiangalia ndani zaidi. Federation, I don't know who mandate the authority to allow teams to play in certain grounds.
When it was safety and security committee, yes. Nani GMT or TN?
Yeah, because I think it's only Kenya.
Yes.
That a team is not allowed to play in certain
at home.
In certain stadiums. Sijawahi kuona mimi.
Because if it's about security and capacity, go play at Mbaraki.
Yes.
See you.
Indeed.
And they also play at Mumias.
Yes.
So, is there a way, and this one I'll throw it to the CEO, is there a way that as Bandari you've put the case forward and said, let's have a level playing field? If Gor cannot play there, kwa hiyo kichaka, then hiyo kichaka ibaniwe kabisa. Kila mtu asicheze hapo.
Actually, there was a debate on that sometimes back when we had a club licensing workshop very recently, like 1 month ago at the Strathmore University. And most of the team is not even Bandari alone. Most of the team came up with that issue and it was taken up by the committee and they said that they liaise with the committee, which is concerned that if it is an issue of security, then it should be upon the home team.
Yes.
To see how they manage that, because there was a way sometimes back when the club license committee said that sometimes back the teams used to go there during midweek so that the fans who have been traveling the team should not make that trip in big number, then they can manage for those matches to be played on those venues. So they said that this coming season they'll come up with a modality of how these matches will be honored in those respective grounds.
Okay, Bernard,
yes.
We need to hear from the players now.
Right, and of course, very lively discussion. They're just giving us a brief overview of the kind of season the club has had and the kind of structures that they have. Mike, it's interesting just seeing Wilson Obung is one of the key figures of Bandari FC. Mm-hmm. And fascinatingly is that...
Ask him why he's called Demabior.
Demabior.
He has a very crazy nickname in there.
Why you call Demabior? El Marabiosho. What does that mean?
It's a nickname for Fally Pupa because
Fally
I like,
Pupa.
Yeah, because I love Fally Pupa music.
I hope Fally has been teaching you some Lingala.
Exactly.
So Wilson, just tell us, Bandari, you've been one of the most, of course, experienced players at Bandari. Now I understand you've transitioned to another role as a team manager. Just tell us, two seasons, finishing number two. It's almost Control C, Control V this year.
Both seasons have been good for us.
Yes.
I think position-wise, the players that have been to the team that have taken some positions that were key, like Farouk, has been tremendous for us. And I think also the management team has done a very good job to try and motivate the players to perform at their best.
How's it been for you transitioning from a player to being an part of the technical bench as a team manager? How is it? Is it easier for you or is it difficult?
I think in one way I've been blessed because I've worked with the people who have performed very well for the team, like my CEO, like Mike has said, that he was the best manager in the national team.
Yes.
I've been learning from him. Mm-hmm. Our late TM Obwaka was my close friend and we could hang out most of the time. So I've been learning from the best and I think what I was seeing from them is what I'm trying to do.
Okay.
And maybe bettering them.
Feli, as the captain, Bandari FC finishing second in the season, it's a commendable achievement, but it almost feels like you hit a wall every time because of God Maya. And given this the fact that this season, the fixtures, Ilikuwa Mipango will be different. Do you feel now with this new system, perhaps 2019, 2020, finally Bandari will be able to go past and actually win the Kenyan Premier League?
Yes, of course, and I think so. And well, first of all, we want to thank God, because we know this journey, we're coming from far. So we are in the hand, and we thank God for everything. I know up to now, everything we will plan, and God will help us.
Hassan, I'm seeing a lot of feedback here. You have a lot of fans on social media. One person is obviously asking Mike.
Yes.
He's saying, why isn't Hassan Abdallah in that team that has gone to France and the team that is going to Egypt?
That was my biggest question.
Yes.
And in fact, seated here with Coach Bernard Mwalala, is the first thing I asked. And I asked him, Mbono kwa hapa, mbono huko France, wafanya nini hapa? I know he laughed it off, but it's a serious matter.
Yes.
Remember when we had Coach Minye here?
Yes.
I asked him, Hassan Abdallah, how best do you use him? How can Bandari know how to use him properly? And at the national team, you're not able to use him. Why is he remaining? Why do we have him in the chance squad? Kumpaka mafuta kusema bado tukufikiria.
Yes.
Yet he's meant to be in Egypt. For me, he's a starter for the national team.
Yes.
Not even bench material.
Yes.
I don't know, Coach Mwalala, you could help us here and tell us. Why do you think maybe he's been left out?
Let me not go there.
He's being diplomatic.
He's being diplomatic.
Hassan, 6 goals. This season mekwa fiti kwako. After umalize Green Academy, najua you were one of the players who was scouted kwa Green Academy, kashinda, I think, Nationals. Vile ulijoin Bandari, ulisikia vipi ndio ilikuwa club yako of choice after umalize high school? Shikilia microphone hivi.
Kwanza nilisikia vizuri, kwanza nilishukuru Mwenyezi Mungu kwa kunipa hii fursa kwanza kuendelea poa. Nilijisikia vizuri sana kwanza. Nilitamani kufika hapa nicheze national team. Na kwanza nashukuru wazazi wangu walinipa nguvu, wanaambia nitaendelea, nitafika mbali. Ndio maana nikafika hapa.
Okay. Mr. Kibageni, of course, you're involved in a different capacity at Bandari. Tuambie kazi yako ni ipi na kwa Bandari. Kwanza hii, the new system, this season ilianza last year, December, ikakuja mbio mpaka May. I'm sure it has had its challenges and its positives for you in terms of planning things behind the scenes.
Sawa, kwanza nataka kusema asante sana. Nataka kuambia kwamba Bandari FC ni timu ambao kwanza kabisa napenda Mungu. Ya pili, tunashukuru sana kwa sababu ile patron tulipata, yeye ndio daraja ametuweka between board and the government na wachezaji. Then tuko na very organized board members ambapo wamesikana, wamepanga, na mimi kama Kibagendi as organizing secretary, that has been my work all through in my life. Kwa mipango, mimi ni moto sana. Sasa tumekuja pamoja. Baada ya kukuja pamoja, what I want to tell you, my brother, all Kenyans, football sio wale watu 22. Football sio eti ni pesa. Vile tumepata ndugu yetu coach, Bwana Mwalala, sio ambao ni wangufu, tunapanga kabla ya game. Na tunapanga tukiwa pamoja. Hakuna magombano, hakuna matusi ama nini. Na hao vijana wetu ni vijana ambapo wako na hekima, wana hezma. Pahali tunaenda Kenya nzima, tukitoka tunapata simu, tunaambiwa nyinyi mnafanyaje mpaka mko na wachezaji ambao wako na nidhamu ya hali ya juu. Ambapo hata ukiwaja pale mpaka uwaite, kujeni mkule, kujeni tuende hivi. Hata mafasi yao pia inakuonyesha ni watu wana hekima na wanamheshimu Mungu na wanaheshimu wakubwa wao. Finally, katika pwani sasa, hivi sasa tunaambia Wakenya wachunge sana. Pwani ni moto, kwa sababu hata wale vijana wanatoka hiyo sehemu sasa wametingiza na wamefanya Wakenya wamesangaa, because Bandari FC inacheza mpira, hata ukiangalia Hata kama wewe hukua fani yao, lazima utawa support.
Asante sana Mr. Kibagendi. Mike, you can see the passion that Mr. Kibagendi, the organizing secretary, has. And talking about passion, as I mentioned in the beginning of the show, Bandari FC is one of the most vocal and most passionate football fans. And you now join Moses Mtalaki, who is in Mombasa, with some of those fans, just to get their immediate reactions as far as the season is concerned. Mtalaki, ujambo, just tell us. Of course, one key thing that stood out was the way that the team has been consistent. They won a title yesterday, the first silver of the season. Maoni yao ni yapi kwenye mashabiki wa Bandari?
Ndomo ni kwamba mashabiki wa Bandari, kuna wale ambao wanasema kwamba kulingana na jinsi Bandari imekuwa ikifanya na kupata baadhi ya matokeo katika ligi kuu nchini Kenya ni kwamba wamekuwa wakifanya vizuri, lakini ukiweza kulinganisha misimu miwili ambayo imeweza kupita, wamemaliza katika nambari ya pili. Na msimu huu wa mwaka 2019 ulipokuwa ukianza, hamasa zilikuwa nyingi. Watu wengi walikuwa wanasema hili kombe la KPL linapaswa kuja katika kaunti ya Mombasa, linapaswa kuja katika pwani. Lakini sikitaka kuongea mengi, niko na baadhi ya mashabiki wa Bandari FC kutoka katikati mwa jiji la Mombasa. Tueleze majina yako alafu maoni yako kuhusiana na msimu huu wa Bandari.
Mimi naitwa David Kidas. Kulingana na mimi, kulingana na mchezo ambao niliona kati ya Bandari na Kariobangi Sharks, Bandari imekuwa timu ambaye ni mzuri sana katika eneo la Mapwani. Na kulingana na mimi, Bandari ni mwamba. Mchezo ambao walicheza ilikuwa mchezo maridadi, na matarajio yetu ilikuwa wachukua nafasi ya kwanza, lakini kwa bahati mbaya walichukua nafasi ya pili. Lakini hata hivyo walijikakamua. Narudi katika makoches. Tunatakana makoches wapange forwarders wale na defenders wawe sawa na wawe imara katika mchezo wao. Na ikilingana na vile niliona vijana wanacheza, baada ya siku kadhaa walionyesha kwamba wana umahiri katika mchuano huu, kwa sababu baada ya kukua nambari ya moja walikosa kuwa nambari ya moja kwa sababu ya shida ndogo ndogo au makosa ndogo ndogo. Kwa hivyo inatakikana kila mara wakienda uwanjani, ile mikakati imepangwa iwe sawa sawa. Wale watu ambao wanajua ile timu ambao watacheza nao, hali yao ya mchezo imefika wapi.
Alafu sasa kuna wakati Bandari ilikuwa inaongoza ligi kuu, alafu ikawa sawa machokeo ambayo wanacheza katika mechi za kaunti nje ya kaunti ya Mombasa yakaanza kudidimia. Mwaka unaokuja labda unataraji zile away matches waweze kuzipiga kivipi?
Naam, matarajio yetu ni kwamba tuna imani na Bandari kwa sababu ndio timu ambayo imejulikana na imeenea katika hali yake ya mchezo katika sehemu hii ya Mombasa. Na matarajio yetu ni kwamba katika mchezo unaokuja Bandari iwe imeshikilia nambari ya kwanza, atakuwa wamekuwa wakichukua vikombe. Kwa hivyo tunaomba wale washikadau wote wakisha kwamba wamepanga timu kisawasawa, mambo iwe sawa, wachezaji wanao wazuri, vijana wanacheza mpira katika hali inayowezekana. Kwa hivyo matarajio yetu katika dimba ambao walicheza karibuni walitokea nambari ya pili, lakini katika siku zijazo tuna imani na Bandari ya kwamba jinsi wanavyoenda kuimarika katika kila mchezo wanaocheza hapa pwani, wakati unaokuja watachukua kikombe hapa pwani.
Upande wa management ungetaka kuona nini?
Naam, katika upande wa management ningewashauri wale washikadau wote katika management ya kwamba hakuna kitu ambacho binadamu anaweza fanya bila kutuzwa. Wapange hali ya kutuza wale wachezaji ili kuwapa moyo, ili wakiingia uwanjani wanahisi ya kwamba hii ndio kazi, hii ndio njia ya kupata riziki yangu. Na pia wakisha kwamba vile vifaa vyote ambavyo vinatakana katika mchezo wa kandanda vimenunuliwa na viko tayari, ili wakiingia uwanjani hawana dosari hata moja. Hiyo ndio ombi langu katika hali ya mchezo ya kandanda.
Mwisho kabisa, ukuzaji wa talanta. Vijana wengi tu wanakwenda pale msimu umekwisha, alafu watapanga, Bandari FC itapanga kwamba kutakuwa na simu za kwenda kufanya training na kuona kwamba wale ambao ni vijana wazuri kutoka pwani wameweza kupewa nafasi kujiunga. Unaona kwamba kuna mikakati ambayo timu ya Bandari inaweka kuona kwamba wale vijana ambao bado hawajaweza kupata nafasi, chipukizi hawa, wamepata nafasi na wamekuza talanta, manake wengi si kutoka pwani wanaochezea Bandari FC.
Naam, timu ya Bandari haikuanza leo wala jana. Ni timu ambayo imekuwa hapa miaka na mikaka. Kwa hivyo tunaomba management wao ya kwamba wakishajenga hii hali ya timu, wajenge shule ya kufundisha vijana chipukizi. ili wale wanaocheza kwa msimu huu wakiritaya na timu iendelee kuchukua na kusajili wale vijana wapya ambao wana hekima na elimu ya kandanda. Hiyo ndio ombi langu.
Asante sana. Naam, ni baadhi tu ya mmoja wa mashabiki wa Bandari FC tukizungumza naye hapa katikati mwa jiji la Mombasa. Jinsi anavyoweza kusema kwamba ni kwamba Bandari FC imejitahidi lakini inahitaji kujikakamua zaidi hususan katika zile mechi ambazo wanaenda kucheza katika kaunti nyingine na timu mbalimbali. Wakiweza basi kufanya hivyo, wanataraji kwamba msimu unaokuja huenda kombe la KPL likakuja katika kaunti ya Mombasa kwa mara ya kwanza kabisa. Bernard Ndong.
Asante sana Moses Mtalaki, of course very passionate fan, very knowledgeable fan as well there, just giving his reflections about Bandari FC. Mike, I think it's important just to get an immediate reaction from the CEO. You've had the fan there just stating, Bwana CEO, that you need to appreciate the players, and I also understand that you're going to do something special ahead of your continental duty. You're planning to go somewhere. Where is it, Bwana CEO?
Actually, the plans are there from our patron, who is the MD of Kenya Ports Authority, through and through the sponsorship of Kenya Ports Authority, which has done very, very good work in terms of motivating the players. We have those plans, and we are still in discussion through our patron. We did this last time before the league kicked off.
You went to the country, right?
Yeah, we went to the patron, give us an offer to Zanzibar, and it was like our camp for the pre-season,
right,
which was very fruitful in terms of players being put together and work together as a team, and we had build-up matches there which gave coach the overview picture of how the team was before the league kicked off. And so this time, even when we were in our last two matches, we had a luncheon with our patron Bwana Manduku, and he promised that the preparation of the team come next season, if we take the Shield Cup, he has big plans for the team, and he promised that the team will go for training in South Africa before the league kicks off. So we are looking forward for the pledge which he has given to the team, and we believe that it will be true as it as it has been before, and the way he has been very close to the team, and the players know it very well, and each and every time he always calls when we are playing to know the results,
right?
And he has been, I can say, more than like as a coach to the team, because whenever we meet with him as a team, he gives us those tips and motivation of winning matches, like the way he did before the first game which we played on Saturday. I mean on Saturday, yeah?
Yes.
The first half, he came when it was almost halftime, and we managed to have a talk with him, and he gave the player very good motivation in terms that, you give me the trophy, come the final second half yesterday, and my plans are still there.
Okay.
So we do believe that.
So it's official, you're going to South Africa?
That is the promise from our party.
Unasema yes. Unasema mpaka upande ndege ndio utajua kwamba
utajua
umeenda kweli. But then Molala, a very good before we go to Mukami, wherever she is in Europe, very insightful information from the fan there. He seems to know the club very well, and that is the balance that I would like you to explain to us. A different ball game now. You're going to play in the Confederations Cup. Not easy at all.
Yes.
Given that most likely you'll have to come and play in Nairobi again, which really annoys me, because you're a Mombasa team.
Yeah.
You should be able to play there.
Yep.
What mix do you have to do now in terms of pre-season, in terms of your squad? Are you beefing up that squad? What areas do you need to look at and strengthen and say, now this team is ready to take on the continent of Africa?
I think at every any coach, when you come to in terms of beefing up your squad, I think it's automatic. There's some areas you need to beef up, and I think for me as a coach, not because we are going to play Confederation Cup, I think I'm not going to do any major changes with my boys. I think I trust them. We have done it, you know, we tumefika hapa. So why maybe say no, I'm going to play international matches maybe, so now I have to get these players out, bring experienced players at such. No, I'm not going to do that. But beefing up, at least, okay, it's normal. it's every coach has to do that. At the end of the season, you have to bring two or three. And I think I'm going for almost six players, Mwisho. I'm going to maintain these boys. I know they can do it. They can deliver, and they will deliver. Because if we, you remember when we played against Simba, Simba mefunga watu wangapi huko nje? Wengi sana. So if they can play like that against Simba,
then ile ile Simba original.
Simba original with the Kagere's wakina Bokos inside. So I think I'm going to just to beef up a little bit, but not that major reshuffling. No, I'm going to maintain my squad because they know what I want. Mm-hmm. They believe in me. And then there's one thing wamefanya kubwa sana, cooperation, adjustment, you know, from this level to the other level. So I know it is going to be difficult, but they are ready for the task.
In terms of development, I was in Spain with the Chapadimba team, yeah, Safaricom, and the top performers of that team all come from Mombasa. The goalkeeper from Mombasa played very well. In fact, so many of the coaches were asking, why is this player playing in a lesser league than the top league of the country? The striker we had, our top scorer there with three goals, also from Mombasa. Have you looked at these players in terms of you tie them down and you look at the development because they already have the culture of playing at the coast?
Okay. This is something that we really need to address it. As a coach, CEO, and one thing I get when I try to maybe to understand why people are saying, "Ha, wachezaji wa Mombasa wako wengi kwa squad." But the door is open. We are at Maraki. We are training there. Mm-hmm. You come if you are at the level of maybe competing with. You're better than Wadi.
Yes.
How can I say no? Well, we have to consider that we are playing top league. Yes, he is talented. Young player is talented. But now, ukimwambia tukuweka kwa junior kwanza, we develop you so that you get to this level. Hataki. Sasa ndio imekuwa changamoto.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, but we are open for any player in the
coast. You see the players, but they don't want to go through the right channel.
The right channel.
Develop ukiwa mchanga, ndio ufike level tunataka.
Yeah.
Ndong, where's Mukami?
Right, Mukami Omora is still in Europe, Michael Kinyi. It seems she's relocated there. She's forgotten about us, but we linked up with her, and she said she's going just to give us an update on what has transpired in what has been an amazing weekend in European football. Mukami Omora, I understand you're somewhere where there are volcanoes. Where are you exactly in Azerbaijan, Mukami?
Then tuwajaribu hapo tusikie vizuri sana. I'd like to ask Feli, when you went to Bandari, wacha nisikie kizungu yako sasa, kila siku unakuzungumzia unaniambia on français mon frère, au unaniambia kwa Kiswahili. Wacha tusikie sasa hii yako.
Yeah.
You went to Bandari at a point where you're my friend and we used to speak.
Yes.
Nikuambia maisha imekuwa ngumu sana, imekuwa tabu. Mimi nafikiria kurudi nyumbani. You went to Bandari. How has life changed since you went to Bandari?
Okay, for me it's a big chance. And I thank God for that, because in that particular moment, I'm so desperate. But I thank my CEO who is coming help me. We talk everything. Then my life changed. So I want to concentrate to play football. So my family, they are settled, even me. So I thank God for that. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Abdallah. Hii mashimo yote nikosa bana pesa nimekuwekea kwa ukuta hapo uwezi pata. Ama tutoe kamera alafu ujaribu tena.
Ah, sawa tu hivyo. Hata ukiniwekea tena nitajaribu kuweka.
Utajaribu?
Taweka.
Kikosi cha chano huko ndani. Unafikiri uko na kitu ya kuprove wakati utaingia kwa hiyo kikosi kwenda kucheza mechi za chano?
Na kitu nitaprove hapo mbele. Kwenda chano nitapata experience kwanza hapo. Na nitamuonesha coach nilipokuwa nayo, nilipokuwa na perform Bandari, penta perform kule Rambe Stars. Mm-hmm. Kwenda chan.
Okay. Asante coach. When you look at team selection, I know it's a dicey topic that you don't want to get into. But do you think that we need a different system of selection? Maybe use models like other European teams where you've got a pool of coaches that identify pool of talent and say, coach, you need to look at this particular set of players, especially even European clubs. They have scouts who go and look at players and tell the coach, you need to look at this one, and this one, and that's how we have emerging talents. Do you think this selection is being fair to Bandari?
To Bandari?
Yes.
For me, I think I cannot maybe go into that about the selection. In terms of scouting, I concur with you. We need to have scouts. We need to move all over and around the country to look for these talents. I remember when I joined Harambee Stars, Fabish was the coach.
Yes.
And he did something that most Kenyans will never forget. So I think we should go back to that kind of way to go for selection. And one thing about the current team that's heading for AFCON, as Kenyans, all we have to do is just to support the team. I know they can deliver. I know they'll do well. And I have my hopes. My hopes are high. We are going to do well. And for Bandari, I think I've been talking to my players, most of them, like Abdallah. And I'm always telling him, Banatulia itakuja tu. Itakuja. So I think just need to continue working hard. And because I can talk for Bandari, but also Kimani can talk for Madare. Then we have owner maybe for KCB.
True.
He believes like four players, I suppose. No, we cannot have 100 players in the team, mm-hmm. for the national team. So I think we just have to go with what we have and support Migne. And I think we can pull some surprises there. Yeah.
Okay. Well, that's the time we had for you today on Monday Football. Next week, I think I need to, when we have these coaches in studio, especially the former players, we need to show you what they used to do. And I've got a couple of videos of Coach Bernard Mwalala. I'm sure he doesn't have them. But I've got a couple of those clips. When Zinedwa Zilizopendwa, then you're able to see what they were doing, so that when they say, I want you to play like this, they reminisce on the days of yore, where they used to play for these teams in the Kenyan Premier League, as well as the national football team, Harambee Stars. So next week, I'm sure we'll be back in studio. We'll have more in store for you, and look out. Next week, we'll have 20,000 shillings on Quickfire, and maybe a surprise will be coming again next week.
Right. Thank you very much, Mike. And also, once again, thank you. We want to just appreciate the Bandari players who honored us this afternoon. The rest, of course, were in transit right now back to Mombasa County. Thank you so much. Thank you, DJ Crossfade. It is 18 days to go to the 2019 African Cup of Nations. Our countdown to this year's Continental Showpiece will continue, of course, the upcoming few days. Thank you so much as well. Enjoy the rest of the afternoon. Mike, I think I'll try this Super Bowl today.